Today, under the lesson Principles of Early Childhood Education, we are going to deal with the effective teaching in early childhood education. The objectives of this lesson is to understand the characteristics of effective teaching, to understand the characteristics of effective teachers, and to understand the role of teachers in promoting learning in young children, and to understand the principles into practices and the quality standards of early childhood education. And finally, we will understand the current status of teacher training and recruitment. A good teaching is the main criteria of an effective teacher. A good teaching is characterized by observing certain basic principles. Like an artist, a teacher should know certain principles which would keep him to acquire the proficiency in his profession. These principles of teaching are mostly based on the principles of learning. The important are the characteristics of good teaching are based on principles of learning. Now, let us see what are the characteristics of a good teaching. The first and important characteristic is good teaching is well planned. A good teacher thinks of his problem carefully and in advance. The order and sequence of events is clear in his mind and provisions are made for management of the whole situation. The good teaching involves skill in guiding. The process of teaching, the knowledge is imparted and understandable traits and tendencies are curbed, but good teaching consists primarily in guiding and directing the pupil and encouraging him towards the best efforts in learning. This guidance is given by the suggestions rather than by comments and creating a situation which will naturally lead to desired type of activities. Good teaching is causing to learn. Good teaching enables the child to learn for himself. It is not stuffing the mind of the child with information. The child learns by himself. Good teaching is kind, sympathetic, and cooperative. A good teacher always creates a cordial atmosphere in his classroom. He or she seeks the cooperation of the learners. He or she always ensures his pupils' emotional stability and security. He is loving, kind, affectionate and sympathetic towards his children. Good teaching is suggestive. A good teaching proceeds on the basis of suggestion rather than dictation. Good teaching is democratic. The good teacher always respects the individuality of the people and the good teaching attempts to create a democratic environment in which the rights of the individuals are respected. In this environment, the teacher thinks that each child is entitled to equal rights with every other children in the class and that he is subject to the same rules with respect to the social equality as other pupils. Good teaching provides desirable and selective information. The good teacher does not try to teach all the information available which he gathered from books and from the experiences. On the other hand, he makes a judicious selection and teaches all that is useful to a good life in the society. Good teaching is stimulating. A good teacher stimulates through his personality and his activities the personality and activities of the pupil. Good teaching is progressive. A good teacher aims at providing modes and techniques steadily. He also helps the child to make suitable progress in life. Good teaching helps the child to adjust to his environment. A good teacher helps the child to adjust himself against the natural forces or to adjust himself against the forces of himself. Good teaching diagnoses the difficulties. It is true that diagnosis of difficulties in reading, spelling, and arithmetic language is rather more advanced than in the social studies, science, literature, and other fields. But good teachers are more sensitive to the needs of the individual than ever before. Good teaching is remedial. Good teaching must provide remedies for individuals as well as for group difficulties. Good teaching provides opportunities for activity. A good teacher keeps the students active. He is aware of the fact that to keep the students disciplined, one must fill the time with work, and so he does accordingly. Good teaching leads to emotional stability in the child. Psychologically, there are very powerful inherited urges in the child which always try to expand. A good teacher knows that unguided expressions lead to wilderness and therefore helps in providing pupil with suitable opportunities which assist in training and sublimating these urges and emotions. Good teaching liberates the learners. The idea of good teaching is to develop initiative, independence in thought and method or procedures, self-reliance and confidence among the pupil so that eventually they are able to attack their problems independently and work out the solutions. The idea of good teaching is to liberate the child. These are some of the characteristics of a good teaching or effective teaching. Now, let us move on to see what are the characteristics of effective teachers. Effective teacher knows their children well and care about the whole child. They not only need to know the abilities of each child, but also what the interest the child and how best they can learn, and how they respond to praise and criticism, and how to get the best out of each and every child. Another important characteristic is that teachers should be confident in the classroom and ambitious for their children. Confidence comes with experience, but it is important to be not so confident that the child might think that the teacher knows all the answers. Confidence makes it possible to try new things and new ways of working in the search to find the best way to help the children achieve. The teacher needs to set ambitious goals for the children and constantly strive for improvement. The teacher also needs to be consistent in the way she is dealing with the children, applying rewards and sanctions very fairly. Next important characteristic is the teacher should be enthusiastic about their work and enjoy helping the children to learn. The children have enthusiastic teachers are fortunate. The teacher's enthusiasm is catching, and the children of enthusiastic teacher often are stimulated to good work. The teacher can show enthusiasm for a child's learning and can make most of the things really enjoyable teaching. She can also show that she is enjoying learning new things and have a sense of curiosity in her. The next important characteristic is that they should form good relationship with the children and support them in their learning. Good relationships are essential conditions for good learning. The children will learn best with a teacher who knows them well and who she likes or he likes them and expects them to do their best. The children needs to feel that the teacher will support them and ready to help them when they meet any difficulties in learning. The next important characteristic is should make clear presentations which matches the child's level. The ability to explain things clearly is highly valued. Many lessons will start with a presentation by the teacher, and this needs to be well prepared with needs of the range of abilities of different types of children in the class. Starting with a story or demonstration is often a way of getting full attention depending upon the subject and the work of the question. Try to maintain eye contact with the children while talking. And next important characteristic is having high expectations and setting challenging expectations to raise the children's standard of attainment. The teacher's expectations is important component of effective teaching and learning. All children need to be given an idea that they can reach high standard through hard work. The teacher not only needs to set objectives for each lesson, but also need to set targets for each child individually. It is then important to check the progress towards the reaching of the targets. the teacher needs to be constantly reinforcing the idea that everyone can make good progress if he or she tries it very hard. The next important characteristic is to aim for maximizing the teaching contact with all the children. The kind of interactive teaching that has been encouraged in the literacy and numeracy strategies has proved successful because the teacher is having an effect on the whole class rather than a small number of children. The next important characteristic is the teacher should aim to see that the children spend maximum time on task. The children learn more when they apply themselves to the work in hand. It is helpful when the children are working individually to make survey of the class from time to time and note how many children are doing the task. And then the teacher should also ensure that there is a good deal of active involvement in each lesson. Learning needs to be active. Every lesson should involve actually using what is being learned with frequent opportunities for problem solving, investigation and inquiry. There should be a plenty of opportunities to gather information, explore ideas, put forward hypotheses and suggest answers. Good teacher involves the children in self-assessment and discussion about what has been learned. Talking about something helps the child to remember. The children can be asked to explain to a partner what they have already learned. So, the next important characteristics is that they should structure the work well and tell the children the purpose of the work they are doing and the targets they hope the children will achieve. It is important in planning work due to defining the objectives very clearly and then sharing these objectives with the children while starting the lesson itself. Then she can revisit them at the end of lesson to see whether the child has achieved the objectives of the lesson. That means whether they have understood the lesson. Then another important characteristic is how well they use the questioning. Questioning is an important element in children's learning. Questioning can have several purposes: to find out the children already knows or do not know about the subject, shaping the line of argument by using the children's own ideas, checking how well the children understood of what is being explained in the class, eliciting concrete examples of principles and concepts, helping the children develop a desire to inquire to learn further on the ones that has been explained. Questioning should help the children reflect on what they have already learned and their memory also. It also helps the teacher to assess how much has been understood by the child. Now, we will quickly move on to see what are the other important characteristics a good and effective teacher should have. A good teacher should give frequent feedback to the children to know about how they are doing, and they should keep a good record of the children's attainment and progress, and the teacher should have effective but relaxed control on the classroom. The classroom should be well organized, ordered and attractive for the children as well as for the teachers. They should make appropriate and effective use of the homework, and the teacher should reflect on the work done and evaluate progress towards achieving the goals. And a good and effective teacher should work well with other teachers and look for the opportunities to develop their own work. These are some of the characteristics in a good teacher or effective teacher. The different tasks of a teacher are to nourish and channel the child's natural curiosity and provide a creating, stimulating environment for the children where learning experience takes place. The teacher's role is there in preparing a stimulating environment. Things should be made available for the children to explore, to manipulate, and to work on the problems on their own. Preparing an orderly environment, where the material should be arranged in an organized way so that it is easy for the child to get used to the activities. And the teacher's role in planning the activities according to the developmental needs of the children. The teacher has a very important role in planning the activities catering to all round developmental needs of the child. Guiding the children. The teacher's important role in young learners is in using the play materials and facilitating learning. She should give the necessary instructions to the children by using simple and understandable language. Providing opportunities to explore on their own and discover new things. The teacher has another important role in playing that posting different kinds of stimulating questions. That means the teacher has a role in giving the child a thought-provoking questions to develop the curiosity of the child in learning. And the next important role of the teacher is developing a scientific approach through observation, guessing, testing, manipulating, exploring, etc. Another important role of the teacher in the child's learning is inviting experts. The teacher can invite experts in the field of puppetry, the creative drama and other creative arts like music to stimulate the imagination of the child. Now let us see what are the principles to be practiced in early childhood education. The child-centered education, it helps the child to become more independent and self-reliant. One of the educational aims during the early childhood education is to develop independence and self-reliance. In this context, the independence refers to the ability to think without the teacher's involvement. Therefore, the independent children can make their own judgments and achieve tasks after continuous process of trial and error method. Independent children are able to make their own decisions after considering many relevant factors such as other people, the surrounding situations, but they are able to have the control authority. That means they can do their things on their own way after a few trial and error methods. So, how should early educators behave towards the children in order to develop the independence? First, they have to attach importance to the voluntariness of the child. That means the own ideas of the child should be given importance. If the teacher leaves the child to do as they like, that will not be developed. The task of the teacher is to see whether the children can achieve self-realization. So, a path should be made where the children are learning for self-realization and are learning to be independent by giving more importance to their own thoughts. The teacher have to discuss and drop hints to help the children when they are stuck or lost interest in their play. In other words, well thought educational interventions are necessary for a child to promote learning. Respecting the pace of development of each child. It seems that crucial point in early childhood education is rooted in and also fulfills the life of the children. It is fundamental that the teachers to prepare a variety of possible activities so that the children can get started on when they are most interested in doing and can develop that activity. In other words, the children themselves decide what they do. The teachers do not just introduce the activities on daily basis. The teacher should keep a close watch on each child and join in their play. One child is different from the other child, so a pace of development should be given for each child. Vygotsky's concept of zone of proximal development can assist the teacher to recognize the individual differences in development and identify the developmental level of a particular child. Zone of proximal development refers to the possible level in the children that can achieve under adult guidance. This shows the distance between the actual development and the level of the child. The principles form the cornerstones for the quality standards to be laid for early childhood education programs. Developing age-appropriate services. The services and programs for the children in the age group of 0 to 6 years have to be developed keeping in mind the developmental abilities, that is the developmental domains and needs of the child, ensuring holistic development of the children. Pedagogies used in early childhood education should emphasize the holistic development of young children, also keeping in mind the needs of special children. Both care and education are important, and linkages between them need to be explored and drawn out. Interlinkages across the domains should also be addressed as the domains of development and not exclusive of each other. Relevant to the child's context. The pedagogy should reflect the learning of the child in his or her context. Transaction should be based on understanding of the context of the child and social background of the family, and partnership with the family and community. It is important to recognize that family as the first context where the learning and development of the child takes place. The family and parents are of importance in delivering the early childhood educational programs. The center of the child's learning in the environment. The child is the active agent in learning, and this has to be encouraged and facilitated in order to allow him or her develop his potential to full extent. And another three points that are important are the teacher's previous experiences, the child's ability to imitate, and his or her life history. Now, first we'll look into the teacher's previous experiences. Previous experiences help the teacher to assess how they should speak to and what extent they should help the child. The teachers can assume the zone of proximal development of the child based on such previous experiences. It is better to avoid giving in too many hints or instructions to the child. Imitation. Imitation is another important aspect of the development of the child. The children are able to imitate how teachers and peers achieve a task, and they will nearly able to complete the same task on their own. Life history. Life history helps the teacher to assess the developmental potentials and think about how to behave in particular potential or particular child development. But do not compare one child directly to the other child. Comparing the child's present situation or similar situations in their own past experiences. All the children can take a step forward if the teacher knows their life histories, that they are having the strong and weak points that can act as a scaffolds. Now, after having understood the standards and services of early childhood educational program, let us now move on to see the current status of teacher training and recruitment. So, today we try to understand what is effective teaching, and then we try to understand what are the characteristics of a good or effective teacher. Then we try to understand what is the role of the teachers, the principles and the standards or services required for early childhood education programs. So, this is all about the lesson on effective teaching for promoting early childhood education. Hope you have understood this lesson. Thank you.